true to the cause, what it entails and what it means. My gratefulness to all of you for standing by and with the cause, irrespective of a couple of demotivating things which happen on the way. But that's life. A lot of demotivating things simultaneously happen. When the motivation is to serve the nation and to serve a certain idea and ideology, because you're fighting a civilizational war, my gratefulness to all of you before we begin with the meeting and show our gratitude towards people who are Corona warriors. The BJP warriors, the so-called right-wing warriors, are also the right-thinking warriors. And because thinking has to be right to achieve the right results, my gratitude to everyone. And now coming back to the subject being Corona warriors in times of pandemic, all I can say is that in our society, across the globe, people did not know what they are dealing with. Nobody knew what one is dealing with, and nobody till date knows how it is to be dealt with. A few things have happened on the way, but people still do not know what really are we dealing with, because the last pandemic which happened in 1918, and which was called Spanish flu. And post that Spanish flu, though, has not really seen a pandemic. We saw SARS, we saw 2008. So I am looking at it a new change, and which is a 10-yearly cycle kind of a thing. And in this time, especially when the Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji took a call for a lockdown, a lot of people had all kinds of things. Lockdown se kya hoga? Lockdown ne economy khatam kar diya. Migrant labor idhar udhar ja rahe hain, vagaira vagaira. Now, I think migrant issue is an issue that is both economic and the developmental issue of the country. We all have seen that over a period of time, the developmental centers have been certain urban centers. But the rural area where the money, investment and everything else should have happened, that did not happen over a long, long period of time, at least 6-7 decades. And to compete with existing circumstances and making them better within less than half a decade is a tough call. And yet our government has tried its best to achieve that and focus on development on the rural side, and rural economy has been immense. And it all started with Jan Dhan Khatas, and now the best thing which country had been looking forward to was doing away with the APMC Act. A whole lot of you come from urban centers, but very, very bright people would understand that APMC Act was a big hindrance in the entire process, because farmer could not sell its produce across the country or wherever the market wanted. And it had to perforce sell it to certain, the word is dalals, who were, the APMC markets were acting as dalals, and they were the touts between the market, the people who are buying, consumers, and the producer, which has been done away with. Now, the agricultural producer can directly send its produce anywhere across. Plus, captive farming is also a possibility. For example, I run a restaurant and I think I consume about 2 tons of onion in a year. I can have a captive farming from a particular farmer and say, look, this is the money I'm paying you right now. At this cost, your 2 tons will be bought by me in this season. And you please grow onions for me. And with the result, the cash in hand thing, the farmer gets, I get assured produce at the time when I need it. And to keep that much of produce as my in my storage, whether it's a cold storage, which can hold on to 2 tons of onions, can be kept. And restaurant owners can also run their own small storages and can keep their produce, which they will require or work upon. This is a very simplistic example of what I have told you. The idea is the economy in rural sector should improve, people should benefit out of it, so that the need to go to an urban center reduces, which means pollution and facilities, everything gets to be curtailed and more services are available on the rural side. In this battle of economy versus life, our government chose life. Earlier, the impression used to be that Indian lives don't matter. They are so much in number. Anyone can die or live. It doesn't really matter. Gareeb aadmi hai, kuch aur problem ke saath hai, marta hai, to mare. Is tarike ka attitude kabhi hua karta tha. But this government has changed that. So whether Indians who were stuck outside the country or people who are suffering because of ailments or people who are stuck in certain parts of our planet or within the country need to be comforted. And every Indian life matters is what the message of government of India has tried to give. So economy, we can always build upon, and economies can be rebuilt sooner or later. World has seen many economic downfalls and has managed to come out of those challenges. But the death of a person or somebody being unwell is a harsh thing which cannot be dealt with, and that cannot be compensated. So whether rich or poor, COVID is impacting everyone and every life. In that sense, the prevention is the protection. There is no other way of protecting oneself except protecting yourself by preventing it to happen. And how do you prevent? Observe the rules of lockdown, observe the rules of sanitization, observe the rules of cleanliness, observe the rules of face covers, observe the rules of physical distancing. And with all these things, you are able to prevent it from happening. Apart from the fact, I tell everyone, please take vitamin C in whichever form. Amla khana hai, amla khao. Nimbu peena hai, nimbu piyo. Guli khani hai, guli khao. Phal khana hai, phal khao. Carrot juice lena hai, wo lo. Vitamin A, vitamin C. These are the things which you must have on daily basis. And keep your zinc intake. Now, all the fruits, vegetables, etc., which have zinc, you must consume. But because we are dealing with pandemic, having one oral tablet a day is not a bad thing. In addition to this, Ayurveda has their own kadha, and homeopathy has arsenium and camphora. Those are also prescription things which everyone can take as a preventive measure. Why I'm saying this? Because no matter how good the facilities are, no country in the world is prepared for a pandemic. We've seen it in Italy, which was far ahead of us in terms of hospital beds per population ratio. We've seen France, which had higher number of beds per population ratio. We've seen powerful countries like USA and several other European countries. Everyone has suffered. So when everyone is bothered about economy, everyone nowadays is talking about money, I think we have to start charging them with the fact that it is not money which is material, because if people continue to die, how will economies work? All of you are a working class, all of you are youngsters, and maybe my age people also, I can see some. All of you know that either you are operating your own offices or you are working somewhere. If somebody falls sick in the office zone, everybody else has to go for quarantine. When everybody else has gone for quarantine, or office has to be shut down because you need to sanitize the space and keep physical distancing, etc., what is happening to economy then? Economy will come to a standstill, because economies don't run in isolation. Economies run on people's involvement. On human beings' consumption. If there are not going to be enough human beings to consume the data, the food, the clothing, the fashion, equipment, instrument, money, what will you do with the money? Money needs to have a utility, and that utility is directly proportional to number of lives which are going to use that. So whatever we have saved during this period, and we have saved lives, that is our earning. And between the debate of saving economies and saving lives, our government rightfully made the choice of saving lives. With the time span, we are hoping that virulence of the virus will go down, and with the result, one can, you know, start working out gradually over a period of time. And we have to avoid closed spaces, we have to avoid a higher number of people, and try and manage things through social media. All of us in this particular program are experts at that. And I'm happy we started using social media at a time when nobody talked of it, nobody even knew the impact it is going to have. So we are the original group which started all this and started taking help of technology. I'm happy to have met, and thanks to Suresh. Glad to have been connected to all of you, because I've been dying to meet all of you. For some reason or the other, one was not able to get connected. So this is one huge opportunity to have met up with everyone and say hi to everyone. Coming to the issue of Corona Warriors, I'm sure all of you have been Corona Warriors. All of you have worked very hard during this pandemic in reaching out to people. And Corona Warriors, who people like us are recognizing, are the ones who are the frontline workers, who are in the hospitals, who are in the working capacity as or law enforcement officers. So we have seen people like police officers, paramilitary officers, doctors, nurses, sanitation staff, sweeping staff. These are the people who have been out in the open to carry out the functioning that people benefit and people can remain inside. In addition to these people, I also want to name a few other services. We could manage our finances, and we could manage our shrunk economy, because there are people working in the back offices of the banks. The cards are operational, debit card, credit cards are functional, other apps are functional. So there are people who are working there, no matter what the result of pandemic is, but there is a sizable population which is working. I want to thank people like electricity supply departments. Those departments have been functioning so that we are getting electricity. Telecom department, postal department, which is functioning and we are getting our deliveries. Other delivery apps, those boys who are working for the delivery agencies, grateful to them that we are able to get our groceries and other stuff at home without having to venture out for at least these things. Our household staff, which is going out to fetch medicines and things, chemists. So there is a large number of service sector which has been working behind the scenes. So today, there is a day to remember all of them, and let's thank for letting us survive this lockdown and close up of economy, where economy may have shrunk, but it was never still, it was still operational. We were all working, eating, drinking, living, and we have been able to live. Another thing which I realized during this period, that end of the day, how much does one person need to live actually? And I came to a conclusion, not really much, which gives satisfaction and the happiness to people are very limited, very small things. The kind of issues all of us have been grappling with are the issues which we have continued to grapple with even during pandemic time. So when thinking from the perspective of Corona Warriors, another set of Corona Warriors are political workers who nobody even recognizes or thanks. But today I want to thank them, because I could do whatever I could do in my own area where I am elected from, because I had a huge team working, operating on the ground. People who will go to the Seva Bastis, people who will go to the migrant workers, people who will be there to oversee supply chain, people who will be collecting stuff and distributing. One could run that kind of logistic chain because there are people working on the ground. So political workers who are doing the social service, my gratitude to all of them, because they are not recognized enough. And I think this is a time to say thank you to all of them also. Thank you to all the social media warriors who constantly updated us. I remember my phone was not switched off even for a minute during these days. And in three turns, we were managing all the calls and managing the entire demand, because from somewhere the demand was coming and somewhere the demand had to be met and somebody was there to support. So collecting and coordinating all this could happen because there was a team working behind scenes. And my gratitude to those people also who joined politics with the notion of service, and they have served humanity, they have served mankind during this pandemic. And I'm sure all of you also nibhaud your roles in your thing, and I'm glad I'm able to say thanks to all of them. But some negative experiences also. And negative experiences, I'm going to talk from the perspective of corona warriors. So all these doctors and nurses, we realized that hospitals could not run without blood donation. Blood donation as it is a tedious task. People wouldn't come forward for one reason or the other. And during pandemic, all the more. But through two of our morchas, at least in my constituency, we were able to get 30 people, sometimes 50 people, sometimes 70 people, sometimes 100, 150 people. On daily basis, in one hospital or the other, we have been running blood donation drive. And on 14th, which is a blood donation day for the world, we are running another drive in one of the hospitals. And we have been doing it regularly. Our morchas have been doing it. Their hands get tied because blood is something they cannot produce in the lab. Blood is something which has to be live and has to come from somebody. And that's where the shortage was being felt at this point in time. Through you, I want to send out a message that please come forward. Those of you who are healthy, who have adequate method of being healthy and immune, come forward to donate blood, because your donation can actually save 6 lives. So one bottle of blood, one unit of blood can save 6 lives, because there are various things which get to be used. Plasma separated, blood is separated. Please come forward and support this cause. Another, and this is not in the hands of corona warriors, because they can do the procedure, but they cannot produce blood. It's for all of us to do our bit. The other thing is cooperation with them. Many a times I have seen that people being very aggressive with them. I think we have to understand everybody is crumbling under pressure. At some places, states have not made adequate arrangement. And in the absence of adequate arrangement by the states, you can't blame the doctors. You can't blame the nurses. You can't blame the technician, because as a human being, they can only handle so much. They are already stressed and overstretched. They are doing their best. It's not intentional. So cooperation is something we all must do, and we all must understand their constraints. Many a times I feel the political will, the political thought has been missing, which should have resulted in augmenting our infrastructure. Because lockdown period is the time, or was the time, when preparations ahead should have been made. We all can come up with certain figures. And that anticipation that so many people are likely to fall sick when it opens up, so many by so many, it increases in this much time. So we have to anticipate in advance that we will be requiring so much of infrastructure, and this is how we need to help. This is how a normal nurse, not every nurse can do intubation. If somebody has to be on a ventilator, intubation is a technical expertise. That technical expertise, more nurses should have been made or trained at doing that. But we have not done that training. We should have trained more technicians, but we have not done that. 2-3 months of time training to a person who's already qualified is something that, in addition to their normal job, we could have introduced, and we could have made them experts at even handling this situation, which we have not done. I don't know how people think and how these systems operate. And I genuinely sense, not because it's a, I can say it's a sense of frustration when you look around. You feel people do not think with their heart. So if you have a heart and a head, the heart and head have to be in sync. And when you sync up the two, you get the right result, because you have to be a solution finder. And that solution finding is impossible as long as people with less capacity or head and heart not in sync kind of people are operating the system. So I feel there has been lack of thinking on our part, and that lack of thinking could have, I'm not saying everyone would have been treated well at that point also, but at least we could have reduced numbers, we could have helped more people, and we are seeing the impact. There are states. So there are states which with very large population have shown better results. There are states with less population have shown bad results. There are states who have made arrangements, and there are states who have not made arrangements. So I think the syncing of head and heart is a must, which I find many a times missing. And that can help the corona warriors, because it's not lack of understanding on their part, but they are overburdened, and we all must understand that they are overburdened. Things can always be managed better in the hindsight, but things have been managed better by us, and it is because things have been managed better by us that we have seen less deaths, less number of deaths in our country. And that has happened because obviously, there's always a higher method of working differently. But whatever has been done has actually been a good practice, because results are for all of us to see. And when virulence was at its peak, and we did not know how virulence is going to impact, a sensible lockdown was the right methodology. We've seen what happened when people talked about Norway and other countries, Sweden, etc., when they talked about herd immunity, etc., and how they have suffered. And even today, the senior citizens, people with underlying ailments, etc., are at high risk. And all of us in our families and in our friendships and neighborhoods need to take care of that section. And we must be in touch with corona warriors also at the same time. So we came up in my constituency, we came up with an act called Doc OPD. Doc OPD was an attempt to give consultations to people at home, because OPDs are not possible. And whoever has a little bit of a problem, you need not go to the doctor. Through video conferencing, you can be attended to. And there are about 500 different types of doctors. So I want to thank these people also, because through net systems, putting the local doctors on board, we could find a solution. And Doc OPD was working well. And I think we all need to come up with these kinds of solutions or expand these solutions so that more and more people get benefited by the system and they are in protective care. Because you can't take, if you, any one of you has elders in the family, you can't take them out, because the risk of taking them out is very, very severe. Can't take them to hospitals, because they may have, you know, things like diabetes, hypertension, etc. It's not those ailments which are going to kill them, but exposure to corona in hospital, which is going to be very nasty to them. So we all must understand the problem, be nice to corona warriors, understand their difficulties, and act on it. latest what I've heard is that all these warriors are facing difficulties with respect to support, and that support from within the families and outside in the society. Both ways it needs to reach them. And any of you who has a family member who's working on the frontline corona warrior, please put up their pictures. We all must encourage, support them, recognize them, talk about them, encourage them. That's what we all need to do. So let's all decide that we will all pitch the pictures. Thank you, Corona Warriors. I will say something. Saurabh will arti it. Suresh will arti it. Let's kind of create a positive atmosphere, because India has been able to survive through this tough period with our kind of resources, because we have a very, very good team of people working on the ground. And that good team which is working on the ground needs to be thanked. Like most of us, these are people like us, whose motivation is not position, power, money, whose motivation is to do good work. And people who do good work only need a pat on the back. They don't need more. Just being nice is what they need. So let's all create that atmosphere that we recognize the goodness around us. We be nice to them and encourage all the good people on our way. Be nice, be grateful. And I think we all must create that positivity. And that's where I want to thank Prime Minister for having recognized that. All that thali peetna, ghanti bajana, clap karna, everybody else picked it up later. We were the first ones to do it. And we were the first ones because our Prime Minister had the oversight and had the forbearance to guide us through that medium. And I think we again did very well as compared to the rest of the world. Corona warriors are facing another problem, and that problem is that not just lack of recognition, but people go up to them and start telling lies. And say somebody has a fracture or a foot injury or other kind of elective surgery, or there is a benign tumor or other condition, etc., etc. For elective surgery, a lot of people are reaching out to these hospitals and to Corona Warriors and telling them lies that they have no fever, they are all right, and they should be taken up for surgery. I think that's a wrong thing to do. If we have any of us in the family who has any symptom, you know, throat ache, body ache, test of the smell, the taste, the senses have gone bizarre, etc., etc., we must insist that 14 days quarantine, 15 days, whatever, they have to test negative for corona, and only then they go for elective surgeries. Telling lies is not a solution, because when people like that go into operation theater, they are contaminating that theater. They're contaminating equipment. They're contaminating instruments. It's not the right way. And you're harming others who are operating on you. By harming the frontline warriors, the society will not benefit. Society will not gain any benefits out of it. So if somebody says, ma'am, my family was positive, but now it is negative, remove the sticker from my house. Speak to the SDM to have the sticker removed. I will not intervene in those cases, for the simple reason that if somebody has to wait for 28 days or 1 month, it's better safe and secure than never. In 14 days, if there is a relapse and I have the sticker removed, I'm playing with the lives, isn't that? Share with the lives of others? Answer is no. You have to intervene. You have to use if people are not getting services, but you don't have to intervene when other people are going to be impacted negatively for the kind of thing you are intervening for. So to have that sense of proportionality, rationality, must stay, and we also must counsel everyone around us. Anyone who's tested positive, any of our friend who's in the hospital or unwell for whatever reason, we must ensure that that person never misses on our company. We must stay connected to that person. We must ask that person's well-being, take care of that person, even when we can't be physically present. Most of the time, it's not the ailment which brings negativity. It's the loneliness which brings negativity. So to cut that negativity, we all are together in this. None of us can win this war by isolating ourselves from others. Emotionally, socially, we stay connected, even if we maintain physical distancing and we end up not meeting each other. But for example, if it's me, I would say, Saurabh, Suresh, Jemin, Pooja, all are with me. Nishant is with me, Sumit is with me, even when I don't meet them. I know I can just call up any of you and say, look, brother, look, I need this done. And I know that will be done. Isn't that? So it's the emotional connect which matters. And we have to give that confidence to each one of us that emotionally we stay connected to people who are vulnerable in our social system. It could be an elder uncle, it could be an aunt, it could be a friend, it could be a friend's father, it could be a senior citizen, our neighbor, whoever it is, just stay connected. And any help that can be extended without being physically there, let's arrange to do that. And let's take that oath that each one of us will do that. And I'm sure all of you are doing it, but special emphasis on vulnerable class and vulnerable section of our social setup. We have to stand by them. It could be our staff. It could be a migrant worker. It could be a young child. It could be an orphan child. It could be anyone who we think is vulnerable right now and just needs emotional support. Rest of it, those people will manage on their own. I'm sure we have huge resilience, and through that resilience, we'll overcome all these problems. But that resilience needs that little bit of motivation. And motivation comes from the good work. And that strength is what keeps us going. And I can just say, all of you in my heart, hold that position that I trust that each one of you is doing your bit in helping Indians, in helping society, being on the right side all the time, doing the right things as always, and being correct all the time. Thank you very much, Jai Hind. Any questions, I'll take them up.
As usual, ma'am, the nation wants to know from you. There are a few questions. First of all, Delhi Deputy CM has reported yesterday that 5.5 lakh patients would be expected by July end. And even in the Mumbai, the position is very similar. So, I mean, how are we going to deal with it? How are we going to cope up with it? Because it seems as if in Mumbai, the government has abdicated all the responsibility. And I think it is the same position in Delhi.
So, I think from my experience, I can say that Delhi and Mumbai are competing with each other to get who is the worst performing area. And reason being, and I give from a Delhi example, when Delhi had less than 100 people who were contaminated, only 100 people, it's not rocket science. You just had to isolate those people, put them in tough quarantine beyond 14 days and track them. So the initial 5 T's were tracking, tracing. You first trace them, you first test them, test, trace, treat, track, and do achieve all this through teamwork, right? These were the 5 T's. Now I feel all the 5 were missing in action, because when you have a small number like less than 100, 70 odd people, or I'll go to the extent of 100 odd people, it's easy to test, it's easy to track all their contacts, put them all in quarantine. I'm sure within a month or so, you will get the result, because you have cut it and curtailed it and you've stop the cycle. The idea is to stop the cycle. Cycle of spread had to be stopped. Now, at that point in time in Delhi, I don't have the knowledge about Mumbai or Maharashtra for that matter. But in Delhi, what really transpired was, in the beginning, hospitals were recording Tablighi Jamaat as one of the columns. By recording, it was not denigrating in any way, but somebody is a Tablighi. I can't call that person by any other name. And by my calling it by any other name will not change the nature of the person. For whatever political reason, the Tablighi word was removed from the column and they changed it to NCT of Delhi. After changing it to NCT of Delhi, they made it into special group. And within a day or two, that special group was also merged with rest of data. Now tell me, if the data is merged, how will you track them? And how, if you don't track them, how will you control them? So there is no tracing and there is no tracking. And if there is no tracing, no tracking, it's going to explode. And that's what we see on the streets today. It has exploded. When Delhi was, initial days were pretty good. And then this Tablighi factor happened. And through that, the pandemic started spreading. By the time we were able to contain it, curtail that, then liquor shops opened. And through liquor shops, the kind of queues we saw and all those things we saw, the problem started happening. And I said, if somebody can be without alcohol for 40 days, can, you know, another 50 days or 51 days is not going to impact that person. Or start home delivery, at least people stay within their homes so that there is no queuing up on the roads. But 70% duty, etc., being collected. And this was the arrangement made. Now, whatever you have done, shows you did not have the sense and foreseeability in understanding what a pandemic is. And that's where I feel somewhere people, not just knowledge, but with wisdom simultaneously and character has to be there. And that's what I find missing in most people. Because being a literate graduate is not just one thing of one side of the story. It tells you understand pandemic. But if you do not have the heart and head synced in line with each other, no point in having that knowledge because you've not executed the plan right. You failed in anticipation and thus you failed in execution. Anticipation, planning and execution are part of the same street, and that street has been messed up because of your political thinking. That's where I come from. And I was laughing the other day. I said 36,397 tons of ration being given to Delhi government by the central government under Food Security Act. And in addition, equivalent amount was given under this COVID. Now, with that kind of ration in your hands, Delhi government distributed 63 tons. I am just an MP. I have no resources. And within 3 days of this pandemic, I distributed just in 3 days 70 tons. I have all the papers. And post that on daily basis. It's not even coming on the, you know, like we tweet only one thing, what we do in 10 things in a day, we just manage one tweet or, you know, somebody is doing something. But we don't even come up with the entire detail. But if an MP without any government resources, without any resources can achieve this, in 3 days I can distribute 70 tons. Imagine if the coffers are, you know, we are taken on board, I would have probably emptied the entire FCI ground. There go down and distribute it to everyone, and everyone would have had the food to eat. I'm sure in my area there is no dearth of food. Food is adequately being represented, but all those people who were forced to leave because they had no food security, etc., that wouldn't have happened. We would have managed to contain it. But I genuinely feel there is a lack of, I wouldn't say understanding, but heart not in the right place. That your priorities are different. That's all I can say.
And same thing has been
Srinivas, wait. I will call out your name. David has a question. David?
Yes, sir. Ma'am, I would like to ask something. Minister Vechadi should form a high-level committee to reopen institutions and higher education institutions. As you all know, everybody is suffering, and online education in rural India is not much impacting, by the way, and today generations, and we have to deal with it. And I believe MHRD or Higher Education Ministry should take an initiative to form a high-level and expertise committee to open institutions and higher educations.
No, I'm sure learning through e-methodology is great, because that's something which most of the world universities today are adopting to. But before we do that, the greater divide in society should not happen. And for that, this cannot work in isolation until unless the net, the speed, the cable, etc. are provided across, and digitization and telecommunication has to work hand in hand with the HRD to achieve this result. In addition to that, we know how some of the people who work in the field of education, whether it's Baiju or others, I will not name, have had investment from our country which has not been very cooperative towards us, and we need to see that if in the education sector, I've heard the similar things are going on right now. A lot of cloning is happening to our usual apps, and a lot of other people who can pump in the money are doing it, if not directly, indirectly. We saw what happened at Google. Also, so it's a complex subject in which physical infrastructure has to be first provided before we go for the software infrastructure. So I feel that how India could do well by creating software and apps, and also the software, because we have huge manpower and we have very, very bright brains in the field. So lack of brains we do not have. That's not something we have to search for. We have a plenty, and everybody, most people are very, very bright, whichever field they may come from. But the investment in the infrastructure, when it comes to the physical infrastructure, whether it's servers, it's optical fiber, it's electricity, the physical infrastructure, we have not kind of invested as much as we should have. And it's here where I feel a kind of revolutionary technology, methodology, investment, etc. need to be worked at.
Ruchika Gupta.
Good evening, ma'am. I wanted to ask you something regarding the education system. Now that a lot of schools in Maharashtra especially, they are pressurizing parents to pay up school fees, which is high, especially IB and private sector schools. They're doing you a favor if they're not increasing the fees by 10-12%, which they do annually. But the fees is so high, and you're doing an online school system right till next Jan. They're not letting students come. So they're going to be safe. So if you're paying a fee like 15 lakhs per student, how do you pay that upfront in the current crisis, and is there any way which the government can help people who can't afford it to pay such high fees? Because if you're doing a public private school, except a public school, all private school fee structures are super high currently. So how do we help those people who are finding this a problem, especially the working class?
Ma'am, it's a catch 22. For the simple reason that people who send their children to private schools, etc., either out of need to establish a certain status or out of the need to feel they are educating their children better, do not have affordability issues, and that's why they are able to send their kids to those schools. And until and unless the fee is paid at and the services carried out, the better service system, whether online or home tutors, etc., will not work, because you need to develop that kind of infrastructure to achieve that particular result. In addition, that these schools internally will have costs because they have to pay salaries to the staff, they have to pay salaries to their teachers, they have to pay salaries to lab assistants, etc., etc. Now, whether school is running or is not running, I hope they do not lay off people and they do not compromise on human resource, because money has to come so that money can be spent. But ideally, I would say that some kind of balance needs to be arrived, that if certain cuts can be given, you know, like some kind of rebate, I would say, rebate on fee structure. I'm not saying make it free, but some kind of rebate so that, say, if I'm not moving out, many of my expenses are cut, in the sense that I spend less on food, I spend less on travel, which is not true in my case because I am constantly mobile even now. But yes, my mobility comparatively is less, that if I get a tank full, I normally, it would last not more than 2 days. But today it's lasting 1 week. So it's okay, 5 days, 7 days. So it's kind of not spent as money saved. So keeping that balance, if the schools can come up with a rebate structure, that during COVID, this is the kind of rebate in school fees that we are giving, not just hiking, but we are reducing. 30% of our salaries have been cut by the government of India. Yes. So everyone's taking a cut and everyone's taking a loss. And it's not personal. It's, we are, again, all of us are in it together. And whatever cost we have to bear, we will bear. I feel a more compassionate approach towards both sides. It cannot be free. At the same time, schools need to rethink to what kind of rebate schools can give, so that parents also are struggling in their businesses and their general management. They should also be helped, and teachers also need to carry back some salary because they also have children to be looked after.
Thank you, ma'am.
Sandeep Gandotra from Delhi.
Namaskar, ma'am.
Namaste, Sandeep.
Ma'am, I just want to know. I just want to know, like, in Delhi, case doctors are not admitting people or even afraid of giving prescriptions. Even I have been getting calls that help somehow to get the test done. And it's actually, we are also getting abused now, that how could BJP let Kejriwal run away with all these dramas he is doing, and Dr. Harshvardhan is also not visible right now. So how to go about it? Because cases are high. Maybe numbers are not that high on the paper, but cases are high. I can see that even in my society.
No, but your response should be Delhi voted for Kejriwal. कर्म का हिसाब तो इस जीवन में सबको देना है भाई. मेरे को बुरा, मैं बुरा कर्म करूंगी तो उसका पाप मेरे को इधर ही भुगत के जाना है. तो अभी दिल्ली ने किया तो दिल्ली भुगतेगी उसको, उसका क्या हिसाब है. और ये सब पॉलिटिकल क्वेश्चंस का पॉलिटिकल आंसर है. ये तो कर्म की थ्योरी सबके लिए लागू होती है. बट आई मीन दिस वाज जस्ट ऑन द लाइटर साइड. बट द फैक्ट इज दैट यू सी, if you check my tweets from day one, I have constantly been flagging from migrant workers. People of Delhi did not speak out. People of Delhi did not come forward to stop. We were all party to that pap karma which we have done. Because that time they all felt, yaar, being so selfish ki migrant, yaar, jaane do, marne do, jo hota hai, hone do. Not knowing ki what you're booking for others, you'll suffer the same. Now, when it comes to helping people, asymptomatic aadmi ko doctor ke nahi jana chahiye. Unko thoda sa samjhane ki zarurat hai, kyunki main sabko samjhati hu. Main kehti hu, aaj agar mera, aap Montu's test karenge, aur main sabke liye lagu hota hai, jo mere pe lagu hota hai, wo aap sab pe bhi lagu hota hai. Mera aaj aap Montu's test karenge, to main tuberculosis ke liye positive aane wali hu. 100% पॉजिटिव आऊंगी। अगर मैं टीबी के लिए पॉजिटिव आती हूँ का मतलब ये नहीं है कि मुझको टीबी है, मैं डायबिटिक नहीं हूँ, मुझे ब्लड प्रेशर नहीं है, मेरा हार्ट कंडीशन ठीक है, एक्टिव लाइफ लीड करती हूँ, उम्र अभी मिडिल एजेस में है, आई कैन झेलो इट फॉर नेक्स्ट कपल ऑफ इयर्स। तो बावजूद पॉजिटिव होते हुए आई एम नॉट इल, एंड इट इज द सेम थियोरी विच विल अप्लाई टू कोरोना ऑल्सो, दैट ऑल ऑफ अस समवेयर और द अदर वुड हैव कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड इट बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ आवर प्रोफाइल, लाइक एटलीस्ट माई प्रोफाइल इज द सेम एज योर्स। 24 घंटे लोगों के बीच में काम करना है, 24 घंटे 50,000 आदमियों से मिलना है, 24 घंटे लोगों को किसी को खाना पहुंचाना है, किसी को अस्पताल लेके जाना है, डॉक्टर्स के बीच में जाना है, ब्लड डोनेशन करना है, कुछ ना कुछ लाइफ में है। तो एक्सपोजर तो ऑलरेडी हम सबका हो चुका है, और उस एक्सपोजर का मतलब ये नहीं है कि हम बीमार हैं, हम सही सलामत हैं और आगे भी शायद सही सलामत ही रहने वाले हैं, लेकिन अभी टेस्ट करेंगे तो पॉजिटिव आने वाले हैं। तो टेस्ट करके पॉजिटिव आके सबको घबराहट में पैदा करना और सबको कहना ना भाई अब तो क्वारंटाइन हो जाओ, गलत होगा, बिकॉज इट विल क्रिएट पैनिक। तो वो पैनिक क्रिएट नहीं करना है, लेकिन हाँ कोई सिम्टोमेटिक है, भाई खांसी चालू हो गई, सीढ़ी चढ़ने के अलावा सड़क पे चलने पे बाथरूम जाने में कमजोरी महसूस होने लगी और खड़े नहीं हुआ जा रहा, सांस लेने की दिक्कत हो गई, सडनली खाना टेस्टलेस लगने लगा, नाक की प्रॉब्लम हो गई, सांस नहीं आ रहा, तब तो सिम्टोमेटिक हो तब टेस्ट कराना है और तब डॉक्टर से दवाई लेनी है। उससे पहले अगर आप एसिम्टोमेटिक होते हुए ये सब करेंगे तो आप सिम्टोमेटिक लोगों का जो अधिकार है उसको हनन करेंगे, यू विल बी हार्मिंग देयर राइट, बिकॉज यू विल बी एबल टू मेक इट थ्रू दिस एलिमेंट एनी वन वे, बट पीपल हु नीड हेल्प एट दैट पॉइंट इन टाइम देयर इज अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ पीपल हु कैन बी टेस्टेड, and those certain amount of people should be tested on regular basis, on everyday basis. If I take their share, then they are not able to get the benefit which they should receive. So people who are asymptomatic should not be tested. There are people who are hyper, and constantly we are all dealing with that class of people jo zarurat se zyada hyper hai. Hyper ki bhai koi normal zukam khansi bhi hua तो भाई मेरा कोरोना टेस्ट करवा दो, अरे भैया खांसी या बलगम नहीं आता कोरोना में, वो ड्राई कॉफ होता है, वो गले में दर्द होगा लेकिन बलगम नहीं है, बलगम है का मतलब आपको कोरोना नहीं है, आपको नॉर्मल वायरल है, और नॉर्मल वायरल भी उसके तरीके हैं, भाप लो, स्टीम लेते रहो, क्रोसिन खाते रहो, जो भी उसकी नॉर्मल प्रोटोकॉल है उसी से ठीक हो जाओगे, विटामिन सी की इनटेक, जिंक की इनटेक ठीक ठाक रखो, अपना काढ़ा वाड़ा जो भी अपनी हिंदुस्तानी तरीके हैं उसको लेते रहो, वो सारे वो आपको कंट्रोल स्टेट में रखते हैं। तो गर्म पानी पीना है, हाथ बार बार धोने हैं, ये सब तरीके अजमाओ, तो हम उनकी मदद ऐसे ही कर सकते हैं। सबसे बड़ी मदद काउंसलिंग की है, सबको समझाना है कि भैया बीमारी ऐसे फैलती है, और उनको टीबी का एग्जाम्पल देके बताना है कि भैया टीबी टेस्ट करवाओगे तो पॉजिटिव आओगे। अब पॉजिटिव आने का मतलब ये नहीं है कि आपको टीबी है, पॉजिटिव आने का मतलब है आपको एक्सपोजर है, एक्सपोजर हम सबको है। और मैं कितने साल से, आपको तो याद होगा कई लोगों को, मैंने कितनी बार कैंपेन रन की थूकने के खिलाफ, याद है, सम ऑफ यू मे रिमेम्बर, मैंने खुद जाके कनॉट प्लेस के जो वाइट पिलर्स हैं उनके ऊपर लाल लाल निशान, अपने हाथ में ग्लव्स पहन के उसकी सफाई करके उसको मिटा के दोबारा से पेंट करना, ये वो मैं खुद अपने हाथ से करके आती थी, क्योंकि मैं सोचती थी शायद लोगों में अच्छाई और इंसानियत बाकी है, वो देखेंगे कि सांसद खुद झाड़ू लगा रही है साफ करिए तो थोड़ा शर्म आएगा, अगली बार नहीं करेंगे, वहां तो अकल नहीं है भाई, वो कहते सांसद का काम है वो रोज आके झाड़ू लगाए, रोज सफाई करे। सॉरी फॉर माई लैंग्वेज, बट द फैक्ट इज पीपल्स एक्सपेक्टेशंस आर सच idiotic and so stupid that they do not understand their part of duty, and the duty is ki bhai mere ko nahi thookna hai, isliye nahi ki main bimar hu, balki isliye ki mere thookne se agla bimar ho jayega, jo bechara diabetic hai, jo 60 se upar wala hai, jiski immunity low hai, koi chhota bachcha hai jiska jo abhi viral se so ke utha hai, to jo bhi kamzor vulnerable section hai wo bimari catch kar leta hai। इट्स द सेम थिंग एज हैपेंस इन ट्यूबरकुलोसिस कि मेरे को बीमारी नहीं है लेकिन मेरे थूकने से जो भी कम इम्यूनिटी वाला व्यक्ति है उसको टीबी हो जाएगी. डायबिटिक है तो सबसे पहले वो डायबिटिक पकड़ लेगा बीमारी को. कोई बुजुर्ग है उसको पकड़ लेगा. कोई छोटा बच्चा है जिसका बीसीजी का इंजेक्शन हुआ नहीं हुआ, इम्यूनिटी बनी नहीं बनी, पैदा ही हुआ है, वो पकड़ लेगा बीमारी को. और जब तक उसका डिटेक्ट होगा वो 2-3 साल का हो चुका होगा. और बीसीजी उसके बाद लग भी जाए तो उसका असर नहीं होगा. तो आई एम ट्राइंग टू से लोगों को काउंसिल करो, आप लोग समझाओ, क्योंकि कितना भी प्रेशर देखो थोड़ा मेस तो क्रिएट हो ही चुका है अभी
साइक्लॉन. दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट का, दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट ने जो इतना ज्यादा मिसमैनेजमेंट कर दिया है दिल्ली में,
मैंने तो आजकल में एक चिट्ठी अभी लिखूंगी, वो मैं नेट पे डालूंगी, आप सब लोग वॉच करना कि दिल्ली के अंदर अभी जो ग्रीन जोन है वहां पे ये लोग कोरोना सेंटर बनाने के चक्कर में है. और वहां पे मैं लगातार उसको अपोज कर रही हूँ क्योंकि रेजिडेंट वेलफेयर एसोसिएशन और सीनियर सिटीजन सेंटर्स वगैरह मेरे को बार बार चिट्ठी लिखते कि हम तो वल्नरेबल क्लास है, हमारी जगहों को आप कैसे बार बार इस्तेमाल करना चाहते हो कोरोना सेंटर के लिए. कोरोना सेंटर थोड़ा दूर रखो, सही भी है, रेड जोन में बनाओ, जो ऑलरेडी रेड है वहां थोड़ा और कोरोना फैल जाए कोई बात नहीं, मगर जो ग्रीन है उसमें रेड करके क्या फायदा. कुछ तो दिमाग से काम करोगे या नहीं करोगे, मगर इस तरीके की हरकतें लगातार हो रही है. सो वी हैव टू कीप ऑन इंसिस्टिंग ऑन द राइट ट्रैक. अगेन 5 T's, टेस्टिंग, ट्रेसिंग, ट्रैकिंग, ट्रीटमेंट एंड टीम वर्क. अभी टीम वर्क का तो जो करना था वो कर दिया है, बट स्टिल वी हैव टू गो ऑन हेल्पिंग पीपल वॉट एवर इज इन आर कैपेसिटी. फोन करना है, दवाई भेजना है, हाइड्रोक्सीक्लोरोक्वीन कोई मांगता है वो करना है, जिंक देना है, विटामिन सी देना है, जो भी देना है वो पहुंचाएंगे ना. वी कैन ओनली डू व्हाट वी कैन डू.
नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन सुमित बसेन जी.
धन्यवाद सुमित जी. नमस्कार मीनाक्षी जी. मीनाक्षी जी, मेरा प्रश्न ये है कि आपको ध्यान होगा कि हम लोगों ने जनवरी के महीने में दिल्ली की हेल्थ के बारे में रिपोर्ट भी निकाली थी, किस प्रकार से इन्होंने दिल्ली का 5 साल में खराब किया. आज हमें हम सबको चीजें सामने आ भी रही हैं. जब कोरोना आरंभ हुआ तो अरविंद केजरीवाल ने 30,000 बेड की तैयारी कर ली है, इसकी घोषणा की थी, टीवी पर आकर घोषणा की थी. आज अब ये कह रहे हैं 8,000 बेड हैं, बेड मिल नहीं रहे, बेड कोई डिस्प्ले कर नहीं रहा. इस पूरी परिस्थिति के अंदर क्या केंद्र सरकार हस्तक्षेप नहीं कर सकती, क्या केंद्र सरकार, क्योंकि दिल्ली में 42% लोगों ने वोट बीजेपी और इनके समर्थक दलों को भी दिया है, और जो बीमार हो रहे हैं वो जरूरी नहीं है कि वो सब वही बीमार हो रहे हो जिन्होंने नाम मांगे. तो इसको हम वोट की हमें कुछ बहुत
सुमित जी की आवाज नहीं आ रही.
हेलो, हाँ मीनाक्षी जी, मेरी आवाज आ रही है क्या?
बीच में गायब हो गई थी, अभी आ रही है. मगर जितना मेरे को आपका सवाल समझ आया उसको मैं एक बार बता देती हूँ. जितना
मैं आपसे शेयर कर रहा था अपना व्यक्तिगत एक्सपीरियंस. सुबह से अपने फुफ्फड़ जी के दाखिले के लिए बीएलके में 8 बजे से लगा हुआ हूँ. जो पॉलिटिकल वो जो अप्रोच लगानी चाहिए थी लगा ली, लेकिन अभी तक बेड का इंतजाम नहीं हो पाया है, डिस्पाइट स्पीकिंग टू एचओडी एंड एमएस ऑफ द हॉस्पिटल.
आप मेरे को एक बात बताओ, बेड होगा नहीं तो बेचारे क्या कॉरिडोर में बेड लगा देंगे?
नहीं, इसीलिए तो हम लोगों ने हमारी व्यवस्था.
आप मेरी प्रॉब्लम समझिए, बेड नहीं है और आपने 8,000 बेड बोला है, असलियत में 3100 कुछ बेड्स हैं और इन्होंने 32,000 की डिक्लेरेशन की थी. मैंने वो हाईकोर्ट का केस और हाईकोर्ट का एफिडेविट भी ट्वीट भी किया और लगाया भी, जिसमें इनके अपने एडिशनल स्टैंडिंग काउंसिल है सम ए जैन, मेरे को नाम अनुज है, अंशु है, क्या है, जैन करके एडिशनल स्टैंडिंग काउंसिल है, उनका एफिडेविट है जिसने कहा है कि 3100 कुछ बेड्स हैं. अब 3100 बेड्स 3 करोड़ लोगों के लिए कहां से पूरा बैठेगा जी? और 28 अस्पताल हैं दिल्ली सरकार के पास, जिसमें से इन्होंने डिक्लेयर किया कि 5 हॉस्पिटल कोविड हॉस्पिटल बनाए जाएंगे, जबकि सिर्फ 2 हॉस्पिटल कोविड हॉस्पिटल बनाए गए हैं, एंड कॉन्स्टेंटली पुटिंग प्रेशर एंड सेइंग ऑल काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स टू द प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल्स एटसेट्रा इज नॉट द सोल्यूशन. भाई प्राइवेट अस्पतालों को जो आपने करना है वो तो इन एडिशन ही करोगे ना, पहले आप अपना इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में क्या किया वो तो बताओ. असलियत तो ये है कि ये प्राइवेट को सामने करके भपकी देकर कि प्राइवेट नहीं कर रहा, सारा ब्लेम प्राइवेट के सिर पे उड़ेल कर 2-4 बार नाटक करके उससे निकलना चाहता है. कुछ एक प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल्स में जरूर ऐसे लोग होंगे जो इस वक्त पैसा एक्सट्रैक्ट और एक्सट्रॉट करें, लेकिन अगर गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल्स की व्यवस्था अच्छी है तो प्राइवेट में कोई जाएगा ही क्यों. असली कहानी तो है कि गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल की इनकी व्यवस्था ही ठीक नहीं है, और उस व्यवस्था का जो अव्यवस्थित होने का कारण है वो डॉक्टर नर्सेज नहीं है, उसका इक्विपमेंट, उसकी प्लानिंग, उसकी स्ट्रक्चरिंग, वो सब घपला घोटाला झलमेल वो सब है. जीबी पंत हॉस्पिटल का ऑपरेशन थिएटर बंद करवा दिया इन्होंने पिछले 4-5 साल में. आप मुझे बताइए कोई बड़े अस्पताल का जो थिएटर है ऑपरेशन थिएटर, उसको आप स्ट्रेंथन करके उस सिस्टम को बढ़ाते हैं या उसको धक्का देके गिराते हैं? वो धक्का दोगे तो लोग प्राइवेट में मरेगा, मरता क्या नहीं करता, उधर जाना पड़ेगा. आप मुझे बताइए, अगर मैं आपके फूफा जी को किसी गवर्नमेंट अस्पताल में जहाँ पे अलग कमरा मिल जाता, सिंगल बेड डबल बेड कुछ हो जाता, वहां पे आप भेजना पसंद करते या आप बीएलके में भेजना पसंद
नहीं? वो तो अगर अगर अवेलेबिलिटी होती तो आदमी कहीं पे भी जाता.
Exactly. मैं आपको क्या कहना चाह रही हूँ कि गवर्नमेंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर क्योंकि क्रम्बल कर रहा है, लोग मजबूरी में प्राइवेट पर डिपेंडेंट हैं, और प्राइवेट पर डिपेंडेंट होकर प्राइवेट को भी लात मार, कम से कम मकान दुकान बेचकर कोई जान बचाना चाहता है प्राइवेट में जाना चाहता है, तो आप प्राइवेट पे 1 लाख रुपया तो इन्होंने खुद अपने से अप्रूव किया है. मैंने, मेरे को किसी ने वो भेजा है कि प्राइवेट अस्पताल का आईसीयू चार्जेस में अप टू 1 लाख आप अप्रूव्ड है, वो दिल्ली सरकार द्वारा अप्रूव्ड है. अब दिल्ली सरकार ने अप्रूव किया है तो फिर आप गाली देते हो कि वो ज्यादा पैसे चार्ज कर रहे हैं. अभी वो पैसे चार्ज करके कुछ जान बचा लेते हैं, उनको बचाने दो, लेकिन बाकी की जान जो आपने बचानी थी आपने क्या किया मुझे वो तो हिसाब दे दो. तो मैं, खैर मेरे दिमाग में एक प्लान है, आज शाम तक एग्जीक्यूट कुछ करूंगी उसके बारे में, अपना ये कॉन्फ्रेंस खत्म करने के बाद, तो आप लोग उस बात को आगे तक पहुंचाने की मेरी मदद करना, क्योंकि हेल्थ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर के बारे में मैं तो खुद आपसे लगातार सहयोग मांगती रहती हूँ, डाटा डिटेल आपसे ही पूछती रहती हूँ, तो आपको भी जानकारी है मुझे भी जानकारी है. जिन लोगों को जानकारी नहीं है उनको हम थोड़ी सी ब्रीफली मैं 2 लाइन में जानकारी देना चाहती हूँ कि जब से आम आदमी पार्टी की सरकार दिल्ली में आई है तो तकरीबन 100 से ऊपर जो मेटर्निटी हेल्थ सेंटर्स हैं वो बंद हो चुके हैं. और प्राइमरी हेल्थ सेंटर की डेफिनेशन होती है जिसके अंदर आउट पेशेंट्स होते हैं, इन पेशेंट्स होते हैं, नर्सिंग स्टाफ होता है, और ओपीडी के साथ साथ इन पेशेंट फैसिलिटी मेटर्निटी की भी होती है. तो वो प्राइमरी हेल्थ सेंटर का नंबर दिल्ली के अंदर 7 पे अटका हुआ है, और जब ये लोग सरकार बनाने से पहले इन्होंने प्रॉमिस किया था कि हर डिस्ट्रिक्ट हर जिले के अंदर हम एक प्राइमरी हेल्थ सेंटर बनाएंगे, तो प्राइमरी हेल्थ सेंटर नहीं बना के मोहल्ला क्लिनिक खोला है, और मोहल्ला क्लिनिक सब सेंटर 2-3 की कैटेगरी 4 की कैटेगरी वाली चीज है जिसके अंदर कुछ फैसिलिटी नहीं है. इट्स लेस देन जस्ट एन ओपीडी, ब्लड टेस्टिंग फैसिलिटी वगैरह वगैरह ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है. अगर मोहल्ला क्लिनिक सही से काम कर रहे होते तो कोविड के समय पर वही टेस्टिंग सेंटर कन्वर्ट हो जाते, वही आपकी लैब्स बन जाती, मगर वो नहीं है, वो सिर्फ एक नाटक है और लिटरली पैसे को नाली में बहाने के बराबर का काम किया है. और कई जगहों पे तो मोहल्ला क्लिनिक नाम की चीज भी नहीं है, वो किसी का रेजिडेंशियल क्वार्टर है और उसके ऊपर 4.5 जो है गूगल पे रेटिंग भी दे रखी है इन लोगों ने, तो इतना बुरा हाल है. झूठ मूठ का फर्जीवाड़ा है. इन एडिशन टू दिस जो डिस्पेंसरीज थी, डिस्पेंसरीज एग्जिस्ट करती हैं 398 या कुछ लेस देन ऑलमोस्ट 400 डिस्पेंसरीज थी, जिसका भी 100 से 110-112 कम हुआ है, वो 272 या कितनी अभी है. तो डिस्पेंसरीज को ही आप टेक ओवर करके अपग्रेड कर सकते हो, इन्होंने वो भी नहीं किया है. सो दे हैव नॉट ऑगमेंटेड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, जो एग्जिस्टिंग इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर है उसी को आप बेहतर करोगे ना, कि उसको क्वारंटाइन सेंटर बना दिया, वहां पे दवाई बांटना शुरू कर दिया, वहां पे टेस्टिंग फैसिलिटी कर, कुछ भी नहीं किया इन्होंने। और लगातार जो हेल्थ फैसिलिटी है वो दिल्ली के अंदर घटती जा रही है। तो और ये जो बाहरी 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 का नाटक किया वो दिल्ली वालों को धोखा देने के लिए किया। हिंदुस्तान के किसी कोने में ये गैर कानूनी है कि मैं अगर महाराष्ट्र आई बीमार पड़ गई तो महाराष्ट्र का अस्पताल कहेगा हम मीनाक्षी लेखी को भर्ती नहीं करते क्योंकि वो महाराष्ट्र नहीं है। ऐसा नहीं हो सकता। गैर कानूनी काम किया और धोखा ये दिया ताकि दिल्ली वाले बेचारों के दिमाग में आए, क्योंकि बाहर के लोग आ जाते हैं इसलिए शायद दिल्ली का इलाज नहीं हो रहा, जबकि असलियत ये है कि दिल्ली में दिल्ली का इलाज नहीं हो रहा क्योंकि इनका इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर क्रम्बल कर चुका है और ये झूठ मूठ का नाटक कर रहे हैं।
क्वेश्चन राज, राज
गुड इवनिंग मैम, प्लेजर वॉचिंग यू स्पीक ऑलवेज। मैम जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू चेक ड्यूरिंग दिस पैंडेमिक इफ यू हैव अडॉप्टेड एनी काइंड ऑफ पर्टिकुलर model in your constituency which can be taken across India, replicated across India?
Okay, so the model is reaching out to as many people in as many forms, and that has been possible because you ultimately I always say social media is only a support tool, but you need people on the ground. So if I have received any complaint through WhatsApp, SMS, Twitter, Facebook, any methodology the complaint has reached me, a person nearby has reached out to those people. And if the requirement is of food, the food has been supplied. If the requirement is of sanitization has been done. If in fact, I set up a group of five engineers in my area, where there was one artificial intelligence guy, there was one industrial design guy, there was one technocrat, and we set up a group of five people. In the beginning, Delhi did not have any sanitization machines. So because there was no sanitization machine and sanitization had to be done, so that half body truck which is used for taking bricks, etc., we converted that half body truck into a sanitization machine by pitching to 500 liter Syntex tank. And through AI methodology, we put the pipeline by six generators across and made into an artificial sanitization machine. And whichever area we will all contribute by, you know, paying for the diesel, paying for the driver and one helper, and sanitize the area. That's how we started. And the same team generated one artificial robo because we were studying up, we were reading up a lot. And then we said, what kills this virus? What kills bacteria? And what is the thing which is 100% sure that the virus and the bacteria can be killed? And then the only way to kill this particular virus was UVC rays. Now, UVC rays are very, very dangerous rays if there is a human intervention in between. So, it obviously, the rays are good for killing any live thing, but they are bad if anybody gets exposed, then chances of mutation, cancer, etc. increases. So, we searched and we found that UVC robo, which is created by some of the foreign companies, each costs something like 10 to 12 lakh of rupees. We created that robo in 55,000 bucks. And we worked on that. Then in my constituency, I have obviously got some friends and some goodwill around. So people come forward to help out also. In every form, people have come forward to help me, and which is really fantastic. I can only through you thank them. So there is a resident who's a tractor manufacturer in one of my areas. He, after seeing me struggle with this model, they sent me a machine which they use for agricultural purposes for spraying chemicals, etc., on the fields. So they got those two tractors in my constituency and handed me over those tractors that you, at least till whatever time, you can keep and keep getting your area sanitized. So one was taken up by another DM of another area, and one machine is still with me. So that's how we have managed to sanitize the area. And about that robo, we tried to sanitize some of the NDMC offices, and we are struggling with some funds. We get something more. We were planning to give 5 such robots to every hospital, because I have some of the best and the biggest hospitals in my constituency. AIIMS is there, Safdarjung is there, RML is there, LNJP is there, Gangaram is there, BLK is there. So I have some of the fantastic hospitals, but largest hospitals in my constituency. We thought if we get enough funding finance, we can give 5 such robots to every hospital in the least possible cost. Then there is a friend who's a t-shirt manufacturer. A friend of mine works as a professor in Princeton. And in the beginning, on 23rd, 24th of March itself, he sent me an email and he said, tell everyone to start using face covers. And so I said, but WHO saying completely the opposite. A face cover is not what you need to use. He said, no, whatever is the research based out of Korea and other Southeast Asian nations, it says face cover is the only way of preventing it. So I was arguing with him. I said, WHO is the master. Then he sent me a website which has discussed, and he took one day extra and sent out the literature that face cover is what you need to use and face cover is the solution. So at that point in time itself, I tweeted about that website, and I said, ghar baithe kya kare, karna hai kuch kaam, ghar ban mein baith ke mask banao, lekar prabhu ka naam. And way back on 23rd, 24th, we started making face covers and face masks when people were not even discussing and talking about it. And a friend of mine who's into ladies' garment and t-shirt manufacturing, I told them that t-shirt cloth is the best material for face covers, and it protects, traps the virus, and at the same time helps you breathe easily as compared to N95 and other masks who are one-way masks. And they are like valves. So sometimes your own breath is contaminating. When we did this, I don't know how many lakhs we have already distributed. Then we learned about vitamin C and zincovit. Every thana in my constituency, every cop in my constituency, we have given them vitamin C and zincovit to everyone in my area. And I have 6 DCPs in my area. And each has about 10 police stations under them, and hand sanitizer. Lo and behold, everybody was handed, and we kept getting and we kept distributing. I can say that when you set out to do a good task at a good job, it's God's work and God helps you through. And I don't know how many trucks of vegetables we have distributed. And in this entire process, we got a message. There is a Gaushala in Noida who needs fodder, and due to lockdown, they were not able to get fodder. Somebody sent out a message to me, and I was like, what do I do? Kaise kare? Bichari gaye bhookhi hai, mar rahi hai. Kaise kiya jaye? And suddenly we found this Okhla Mandi, which had a palak ka truck. So we picked one palak ka truck and sent it out. One day we sent out tarbuz ka truck. So we managed to look after animals, humans, senior citizens, sanitization, I think, and blood donation, anything, any problem, anywhere. Connectivity is what helps you understand the area better. People on the ground whose goodwill you enjoy carry out the distribution activities, and you learn on the way. So there has been a huge learning experience in this corona pandemic. When I have initially, we started with our own funds, but subsequently I've never received any money from anyone, but there has never been shortage of resources. If somebody met me and they said, I run a destitute home, and there are about 800 people who have been abandoned by their families, who are sometimes mentally not fit, and they are destitute, they are on the streets, and this man actually looks after them, and I need ration for that. And I was like, okay, aapko kya chahiye? He said, I need 500 kgs of atta, 500 kgs of chawal, and 500 kgs of dal. And I was like, ki maine pata kiya, but ratio is wrong. You need 600 kgs of chawal. You need 300 kgs of atta, because atta gundna padta hai, roti banana mushkil kaam hai. So 400 of atta and 300 of dal will have the right proportion. I just walked out, and suddenly I moved out, and suddenly I get a call from one of our guys, Abhimanyu, or some of you may know. He said, ma'am, there is someone who wants to help. I said, to bejo na truck, phala jage bej do. It just happened. It just, and I said, God is there. God is there to get the right things done, and it chooses people to do the right things. So I feel very nice that one has been able to assist, and one has been able to put things together and never had to struggle through these phases. I mean, things just happen like this. So you had an information, somebody needs help, you have someone who's helping, sanitizer cut, I get a call, I get the sanitizer, everything just happened. And in this, somebody says they can't cook because they are migrant labor. Kahan jayenge, kya karenge? I think for almost 2 months or so, we were supplying 1,200 plus food packets just in one area. And those kind of kitchens we have run all across. Somebody wanted milk. So milk and bread, milk, bread, bananas were being supplied to the kids. It's a very humbling experience. And I think a decent thought, a good thought, head and heart synchronized, things just go your way. And that's the model everyone needs to replicate.
Sune na hole.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
How are you?
Good, thank you, Sunaina.
I'm a big fan of yours.
Thank you.
For all your fiery speeches.
Thank you.
Mom, I have a question. I have got two things to ask you.
Yeah, please.
One is, why center is not interfering in Maharashtra when things are going so bad, there is no control over the situation by anyone from the government?
See, technically, we cannot interfere. We are a quasi-federal structure in which states have their own responsibility, their own response systems. Until they ask for some help, we cannot directly intervene. I cannot tell Delhi government. I mean, ideally, if somebody was listening to me, we would have augmented the infrastructure just like that. Because seeking help from someone is not a bad thing. It's a good thing that you can ask, and you're not asking personally for yourself, but you are asking for the region. So instead of saying, I need 550,000 crore rupiah and things like that, this is not the way, because 277 crore is what Delhi has already been given by the center. So if you have the wherewithal, you need to plan, and the planning has to be existing infrastructure and how existing infrastructure can be built upon, and what all you need for building. So you need to put a team of experts, start listening to people, through virtual methodology. I have 20,000 ways of handling this, problem. But someone has to.
When we say there has to be a planning, there is no planning here.
My point is, the people who are supposed to plan are planning everything else other than rescuing people. They are planning ki 12 baje ki press conference mein kya bolna hai. And I was saying the same thing. I said, yaar, press kaam karke kiya jata hai. you do something and then you make an announcement, samajh aata hai. But if you look around, you will see there are many leaders who do nothing other than press conferences. Many people. Unse poochho apni constituency mein kya kiya, kahan gaye, kya kaam kiya, kya rescue kiya, kuch bhi nahi, press conference. That's it. That's what they do.
Bharat Sanghvi.
So there.
Bharat
Sanghvi. Sir, I have another thing, ma'am.
Sunena, if time permits, we'll take.
Sir, I'll keep it very short. This is very important. I have to tell, ma'am.
Go ahead.
Very short. Ma'am, there is Devi Shetty Hospital. So they were telling that the private hospitals, if it's a 200 bed hospital and 20% has been allocated for COVID patients, so uska 20% is also not allocated.
That's
and they are not taking patients.
So state governments have to take care of that. They I mean, I am the last one to kind of comment about all this, but the fact is, how much in what? So the state governments have the authority, because health is a state subject, to deal with such exigencies and emergencies, and also Pandemic Act, under which they can guide and they can tell people what to do. But again, the question is whether their own resources, their own government hospitals, are being used to the optimal level. Answer is yes or no, depending on that.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Bharat Sanghvi.
Thank you, Suresh bhai. Hello, ma'am. Myself, Bharat Sanghvi. I am from Mumbai, Maharashtra. As you have said just now, that one of the main reasons for the spreading of the coronavirus was Tablighi Jamaat. But simultaneously, one more point is there, that is the fake news behind, which also has created many roles in spreading the coronavirus in India. So doesn't government can intervene in spreading fake news, can do something when corona warriors were attacked or something like that? Government has come out with an ordinance. So can't government come out with such an ordinance to stop the fake news, which is also damaging the spreading coronavirus, as you say, can migrant workers and all that. So can't government also come out with an ordinance to stop fake news? That's my question is.
No, fake news has its own implication, and for that, all these platforms are not operating as platforms, but they are operating as publishing sites, and they have the authority to edit or not to edit. And most of these are government onto themselves. Government intervention is the least, and there is, very little government can intervene, because most of the jurisdictions are either California or something else. So that's a separate issue altogether. We are still in the process of coming up with an enactment. If any of you guys are interested in sending some suggestions, I look forward to that.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Srinivas.
Shriniji.
इतने सारे माइग्रेंट लेबर्स आ रहे थे, गवर्नमेंट ने गरीब कल्याण योजना चालू की और इतना पैसा दिया स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स को, स्टिल वो आ रहे थे. और एमपी में जब वो जैसे ही बॉर्डर एंटर करते थे, वो देवर सेइंग कि हमने पहली बार 12 घंटे बाद खाना खाया है. मैंने अपनी आंखों से रोते हुए देखा है लोगों को, उनके वीडियोस हैं. और इस सिचुएशन में भी अगर गवर्नमेंट अगर कोई एक्शन नहीं ले रही है अगेंस्ट स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, आई नो कि इट इज नॉट लाइक कि इंस्पेक्टर नहीं है सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट और स्टेट गवर्नमेंट के पास इतनी समझदारी होती है, लेकिन इस सिचुएशन में भी हम अगर 356 या ऐसे सिचुएशन में हम वो नहीं कर का यूज कर सकते. सेकंड थिंग मैम, मेरा एक एजुकेशन को लेके है. आर वी गोइंग टू स्टार्ट स्कूल्स वेरी सून? बीइंग अ पेरेंट मेरे लिए बहुत बड़ा क्वेश्चन. थैंक यू।
देखिए स्कूल्स के जहां तक शुरू करने की बात है, मुझे तो वो जानकारी नहीं है कि स्टेट्स क्या चुनती हैं, क्या चूज करती हैं, क्योंकि हबड़ तबड़ में स्कूल शुरू करके बच्चों को बीमार कर दे और फिर आपको बच्चों के स्पेशल वेंटिलेटर्स होते हैं, वो वेंटिलेटर्स भी ना मिले, उसका आपका एडिक्वेट प्रोटेक्शन ना हो, तो उससे तो एक साल खराब हो तो वो भी चलेगा। सॉरी फॉर माई लैंग्वेज, किसी कोई बच्चे का नहीं होना चाहिए, बट आई वुड चूज चाइल्ड लाइफ ओवर एनीथिंग एल्स। वो पढ़ाई हो जाएगा, अगले साल हो जाएगा, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, 6 महीने बाद हो जाएगा, इट्स बेटर टू सेव द चिल्ड्रन, दैट इज वॉट माई आउटलुक वुड बी। बट आपका जो 356 वाला प्रश्न है, मेरा सीधा जवाब है कि जहां भी हमारी राज्य सरकारें हैं वहां पर हमने राज्य सरकारों के माध्यम से काम करने का प्रयास किया है, और जहां भी हमारी राज्य सरकारें नहीं है वहां हमने पार्टी के माध्यम से काम करने का प्रयास किया है। मुझे दिल्ली के नजरिए से अगर मैं देखूं तो मैं जिस क्षेत्र से आती हूं वो एक तरीके से कहा जाए तो सबसे ज्यादा अर्बनाइज कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी है हिंदुस्तान की, और इस अर्बनाइज कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी में मेरे को कुछ एक लोग खराब जरूर होंगे, ऐसा नहीं कि सब ठीक होंगे, लेकिन ज्यादातर जो भी भारतीयों का मन है और जैसे लोग हैं, सब के सब मदद करने वाले लोग ही मिले हैं। हर एक का मन पसीजा है टुवर्ड्स माइग्रेंट फूड वाटर। मैं कल हिसाब लगा रही थी, पुलिस वाले फेस मास्क फेस शील्ड, हमारे को कहीं से 3D प्रिंटर 3 मिले, सिर्फ 3 3D प्रिंटर थे, उन 3 3D प्रिंटर से हमने फेस शील्ड बना बना के पूरी पुलिस फोर्स को दिया। तो व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज, नॉर्मली पीपल बाय नेचर आर हेल्पफुल इफ यू स्टैंड फॉर अ कॉज एंड यू आर ट्रू टू द कॉज। तो जहां पे सरकारें मिसिंग थी वहां बीजेपी इन एक्शन थी, जहां सरकार हमारी है तो वहां सरकार ही एक्शन में थी। 356 हम नहीं लगा सकते, वो एक मतलब हम कांग्रेस पार्टी नहीं है ना जी, उनको बहाना चाहिए होता था 356 लगाने का, हमें बहाना नहीं चाहिए 356 लगाने का। अभी जो कुछ बन पाएगा सुधारने के लिए, जो जितनी मदद मांगेगा उसको हम मदद पहुंचाएंगे। एम्फन में हमने देखा कि वो भी मदद किया गया केंद्र सरकार द्वारा, राज्य आज भी कहेंगे तो 2 मिनट के अंदर अस्पताल खड़ा करना, वेंटिलेटर्स लगाना, लोगों को ट्रेनिंग देना कोई बड़ा काम नहीं है, वो कर देंगे, पर बशर्ते कुछ प्लानिंग तो हो। कुछ प्लानिंग नहीं करोगे अभी केंद्र क्या इंटरवीन करेगा। वो 356 वैसे ही सबके सब, एक तो काम करो ऊपर से गाली खाओ। डेमोक्रेसी में ऐसा नहीं चलता है, डेमोक्रेसी में लोगों की आवाज होती है और लोगों की आवाज का पालन करना होता है। तो चलो ऐसे नहीं तो किसी और तरीके से लोगों की मदद करेंगे, मदद करने के लिए बैठे, जैसे भी हो पाएगा वैसे मदद करेंगे।
पुनीता तो सर,
अनम्यूट unmute
hello
Haan,
I can hear you. Actually Sunaina asked the question that I also wanted to ask, why can't the center intervene in, you know, Maharashtra? My maid, she lost her life last week, and they had no hospitals. Then in the morning when she went to the loo, she fell down over there, nobody looked at her till her husband went searching for her. You know, the situation is really bad. And now I don't know what is happening with her family also, whether they have been tested, not tested. They are saying वो COVID नहीं आया, death certificate में क्या लिखा है, बोलते COVID लिखा है। फिर मैं बोली तो तुम लोगों को भी होगा ना, if she was suffering then why you all should also be tested. So that is also not happening in Maharashtra. They're not testing.
Sorry to cut you short. Even if they are not tested, they should people like you should support. And get them into quarantine themselves. They quarantine themselves.
No, give them, but I'm telling them, they are saying for 2. She only had breathlessness. She did not have COVID. I mean, no, that's what they're saying.
No, no. So I am saying there is a lot of lack of awareness, especially in certain section of our society. We have to make everyone aware and support them. एक दो तीन महीने का तनखा जेब से जाता है तो जाके उसको दे दो.
तनखा तो हमने ट्रांसफर कर दिया लेकिन
और उसको तो लोग घर में रहे.
Track trace is not happening.
I can imagine वो नहीं होगा अभी. Whatever I always say मैं भगवान नहीं हूँ, सब कुछ सबका सब कुछ नहीं कर सकती, लेकिन जो मेरे हाथ में मैंने वो कर दिया. I can only do as much as I can do. So what you can do, I can say that कि अगर महीने का तो दो महीने तीन महीने का तनख्वाह देके उसको कहना है भैया एक महीने तक आप अपने घर से बाहर नहीं निकलेंगे, कुछ एक्स्ट्रा काम नहीं करेंगे, और ये लौंग दालचीनी इलायची ये वाला काढ़ा आपके घर भेजा जा रहा है, ये दो वक्त पीना है और खाना अच्छा खाना है, और रोज का एक थोड़ा प्रोटीन ऐड करो, दाल चावल चना जरूर खाओ, चना जरूर खाओ, ऐसे करके यू नो वी हैव टू हेल्प देम इंक्रीज देयर इम्यूनिटी, वी हैव टू हेल्प देम विद गुड न्यूट्रिशन, वी हैव टू हेल्प देम फाइट ओवर दिस. और बुखार आए तो क्रोसिन खाओ, पंखा नहीं है तो एक पंखा मेरी तरफ से घर में लगाओ, पंखे के नीचे रहो, यू नो टेक केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ, रोज नींबू पियो, रोज आंवला खाओ, नहीं मिल रहा है तो पाउडर आंवला भेज दो उसके घर में कि दो फाक रोज का पानी के साथ खा जाओ. I'm just suggesting कि जो कुछ हम कर सकते हैं वो हम कर देते हैं, बाकी तो भगवान मालिक है, बिकॉज अभी कुछ जगह तो लिटरली भगवान भरोसे ही चल रही है,
भगवान भरोसे ही है महाराष्ट्र.
हाँ मैं इसीलिए अभी सो ऑल आई कैन से अभी मैं टेस्टिंग के लिए कुछ भी नहीं भेज सकती, मैं उसको भर्ती के लिए कुछ भी नहीं कर सकती. अगर वो कोविड से मरी है तो सीधी बात है कि परिवार में सब कोविड पॉजिटिव है. वो कोविड पॉजिटिव होने के साथ हो सकता है एसिम्प्टोमैटिक है. एसिम्प्टोमैटिक को हम ठीक कर सकते हैं कि वो घर से बाहर ना निकले, दो तीन महीना आराम करे, और जो भी उसका उपचार है वो उपचार करे. तो उपचार में जो घर बैठ के मदद हो सकती है, आई थिंक पीपल लाइक यू शुड कम फॉरवर्ड एंड हेल्प. और उनको समझ नहीं है, उनको पता भी नहीं है, आंवले का पाउडर बनाओ उसके घर भेजो, बोलो घर में रोज सब दो चम्मच एक सुबह एक शाम को सबने खाना ही खाना है, यही तुम्हारा दवा है. लहसुन दो पोरी सुबह खाना है दो शाम को खाना है, यही आपका दवा है. नहीं तो ड्राई लहसुन का उसको कैप्सूल भेज दो, वो सोचेगा दवाई है, भले लहसुन है वो भेज दो उनको दालचीनी. दैट्स द ओनली थिंग वी कैन डू एंड आई थिंक वी शुड एनकरेज ऑल दिस. अभी जो मदद जितना हम अपने से कर सकते हैं वही कर सकते हैं. अब जो व्यवस्थाएं हैं वो ठीक होते होते टाइम लगेगा, जो होगा भगवान भरोसे. आई कैन फील आई फील वेरी सैड एंड सॉरी बिकॉज आई सी इट ऑल द टाइम एंड आई फील बैड अबाउट इट. मेरे को रोज सुबह शाम यू नो वन ऑफ आवर काउंसलर्स लॉस्ट हिज वाइफ. He was out every day working for the people, and his wife already had an underlying condition of cancer. And during Corona, she died. She tested positive. She was in the hospital.
Kya karu? I mean, it was hail and party. No problem.
During this period, I have seen many people who gone because of this. So, and by the year end, I think we will see a lot more people in our circuits going away. So, jo vulnerable class hai, usko protect karna is something we all must undertake.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My slim friend Suresh N from Bangalore.
Hi, Suresh. Unmute.
Yeah. Namaste, Meenakshi ji. Yeah.
Namaste.
Yeah, I did not have a question. I just wanted to step out because I'm working for the war room here for the state government. Okay, I work for the COVID-19 war room. So it was bulletin time. So I pinged him telling that I'll be stepping out with due respect. So I don't want to be looking rude stepping out.
No, Suresh, thank you very much, and I must compliment you because Karnataka is doing very well in taking care of migrants, in looking after people. Bangalore has done very well in terms of sanitization, so hats off to you. That's what good governance is all about. Thank you for participating and being a corona warrior yourself.
Thank you so much. But actually, the due respects to the chief minister and the entire leadership here. The political leadership has been extremely good here.
We are very proud of our government.
Yes, me too. So I'll just take leave, madam. So I'll just catch you another time.
Absolutely. Please. Thank you.
Malay Mehta. Malay Mehta. Hina Prasoon.
Hello. Yes.
Yes, Malay, go ahead.
Namaste, madam.
Namaste, Malay.
मैडम हम 3 साल पहले मिले थे पहले पार्लियामेंट हाउस में
जी
मैडम ये मेरा क्वेश्चन दिल्ली की सिचुएशन पर है हम रोज रोज देख रहे हैं न्यूज में एज अ बीइंग अ नेशनल कैपिटल ऑफ कंट्री दिल्ली पे क्या सेंटर कुछ नहीं कर सकता है क्या
नहीं अब सेंटर अपने अस्पतालों में जो कर सकता है वो कर रहा है भाई आप एम्स की कैपेसिटी बढ़ा दोगे झज्जर में एम्स खड़ा कर दोगे सफदरजंग को ठीक कर दोगे आरएमएल में बेड्स बढ़ा दोगे जो अपना इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर है उतना इंटरवीन आप कर सकते हो मगर उसके अलावा आप क्या कर सकते हो आप दिल्ली सरकार के अस्पतालों को या राज्य सरकार को पैसा कहाँ खर्च करना है कैसे करना है वो तो नहीं समझा सकते और
दिल्ली सरकार को मैडम ऐसा लग रहा है जैसे 5.5 लाख के सोने के वो वेट ही कर रहे ऐसा लग रहा है
नहीं उसका कोई मामले कोई रास्ता ही नहीं है मतलब मैं क्या बोलूं आप मेरे को बताओ म्यूनिसिपैलिटीज का काम सफाई रखना है म्यूनिसिपैलिटी के जितने वर्कर्स हैं उनको सबको समन करके कोरोना वार्ड्स में उनकी ड्यूटी लगा दी गई और दिल्ली के जितने स्कूल्स हैं उन सब में भी स्वीपर्स हैं इंडस्ट्रियल बोर्ड्स हैं एनवायरमेंटल बोर्ड्स हैं उन सब में भी क्लास फोर एम्प्लॉयज वगैरह तमाम तरीके के लोग हैं टीचर्स हैं उनमें से किसी की ड्यूटी नहीं लगाई गई और जब तनख्वाह देने की बात आती है तो म्यूनिसिपैलिटी के स्वीपर क्यों आप तनख्वाह देने में गड़बड़ करते हो आप मुझे बताओ कैसे प्रशासन चलता है जी
प्रशासन पे वैसे करोड़ों खर्च होते हैं
नहीं पर आप नहीं समझा सकते ना दिल्ली वालों ने जो कर्म किया उसका भुगतान इसी जन्म में करना है
सही बात है
अगला जन्म नहीं होगा वो तो जो कर्म है वो हाथों हाथ इस हाथ दे उस हाथ ले जो लोगों ने भी सिस्टम को खराब यू नो डेमोक्रेसी हैज दिस ब्यूटी लोगों को वही शासन मिलता है जो वो डिजर्व करते हैं आप ही नहीं सुधरोगे तो वही शासन मिलने जा रहा है ना आपको भुगतो आप ही की मर्जी के लोग हैं अच्छे आदमी को दोगे तो अच्छा आदमी गधा बन के सुबह से रात तक करेगा आपको पसंद जो था वो वैसे ही करेगा अब आप अपनी पसंद के लिए भुगतान करो
हिना प्रसून Hina Prasoon.
Namaste, madam. I'm Hina Prasoon from Mumbai. Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, you are audible, but your screen, you're coming in a corner where I have got some notification. I'm trying to close those notifications, I'm not able to.
Okay.
Tell me.
Shall I ask a question?
Please.
Ma'am, I always wanted to meet you in person, and I am very happy to see you and talk to you. Digitally, thanks to Suresh Ji. I have one question, ma'am. As for example, you or Suresh Ji, you guys are one man army. So when it comes to fake news and their rebuttal, so why do our BJP spokesperson go toothless and they don't have that spark which is visible in you or Suresh Ji or Sambit Patra? So you need to train them properly because we are here, we are social warriors, but you guys are the front line warriors. So I had that suggestion.
Thank you for your suggestion. We'll take it forward.
Like issues like migrant laborers, they went out of hand and it was not something as big as it was projected. So,
No, we'll take your suggestion.
Saurabh Singh ji.
Good evening, ma'am.
Hi, Saurabh. How are you?
Very good, ma'am. Long time, ma'am. Aapko abhi belated happy birthday bhi.
Thank you,
ma'am.
इस बार ड्यू टू कोविड वी कुडंट मीट एंड ऑल इट्स बीन रियली लॉन्ग टाइम मैम
बट थैंक यू वेरी मच आई वाज रिमेंबरिंग यू एक्चुअली आई वाज टॉकिंग टू प्रणय
राइट
एंड वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट रक्षा एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी कनेक्ट I said I was the first MP to have started. It's a different matter. Others usurp my place, so it's okay. That's life.
Right. Ma'am, as such, I don't have any questions. Just wanted to congratulate you, I mean, with all the good work what you're doing. I mean, we keep watching your tweets and everything. One thing I was just thinking, ma'am, because due to right now what Kejriwal and Aam Aadmi Party is doing nothing in Delhi. Unka roj ka, they are like launching new ads and doing press conference with Delhi New Lies and all those things. So just one suggestion that a lot of BJP people and the warriors who have done so good in terms of being a corona warriors, they have served to a lot of people, which actually the Delhi government haven't done. So I think, ma'am, we should, you know, recognize and we should do some kind of event where we should give them some awards or recognition in front of all. That way, by that way, I mean, the people of Delhi will come to know that Kejriwal and the party has done nothing, and these are the real people. The real people from within the Delhi Janta have taken this initiative. So that was just one thought that we were thinking.
So through a group, at least the frontline workers, we are trying to recognize in the hospital itself, and I may do something on 14th also. So whenever we do a press, whenever we do a blood camp, we simultaneously recognize the frontline warriors on the same day, especially from the medical community and from the police community. When we go and give them, we were giving them sanitizers, etc. At that point in time, we recognize people. I've sort of written letters of commendation, etc., etc. Recognizing my own workers, in the sense the BJP guys who are working on the ground, their recognition is from the people, because people in that area recognize who came to their house, who gave them food, who looked after them, who is the one who's the sincere and the nicest of them all. That's the biggest recognition political workers get and will like to get. Having a full throttle program, etc. right now will not be a correct thing to do, because this is a long battle which we have to constantly go on fighting. I mean, I know that some of the people and some of the areas, Feed the Needy has shut down. In my area, it is still going on. Every day, there are packets and packets of ration which are going out. Every day, there is demand. Every day, there are kitchens which are running. So it's an ongoing process, and doing you know, other than giving a pat on the back, tweeting about them, making a comment, making a call and say thank you and good you were there, and I know who I can depend on in a particular area and how things have to be moved, is what I can do at my individual level. But if I arrange a program, that will get more negative publicity than positive publicity right now.
Yeah,
I mean, so I think it's individual effort which we have to sort of appreciate and continue. And all of you can kind of join me in that chorus and build that ecosystem, that if I say that thank you, Ravi Tavar, for helping people in the area, you all guys also clap for him and say thank you very much. That's how we build recognition and brands around people who need to be, you know, again, pat on the back is what they expect from us and nothing more than that. And I couldn't have done anything had this team on the ground not been there, because I can't be physically present everywhere. It's these guys.
Right.
I am making arrangement, but my arrangement has to reach people. And unless there are people on the ground, that arrangement is useless. What will the arrangement do? Right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next question is Savita Rao and Pranjal after that.
Namaste, Meenakshi ji.
Namaste. Namaste, Savita ji.
I'm from Mumbai, and it's a pleasure to see you. I've really appreciated your speeches in Parliament. You bring logic and articulation and passion so brilliantly together. And today, hearing all that you've done for your constituency, I feel that your constituency is blessed to have a dedicated and a committed person like you. And when I look back at my own constituency, you know, our MP is Mr. India. You know, we haven't seen him. He's invisible. He's from Shiv Sena. So that, I guess, explains why he's Mr. India. And, you know, the karma theory that you've been sharing in this discussion, our karma was that we voted for BJP. So I can only conclude this is some past janam ka karma ka, you know, result that we are enduring this three idiot sarkar at this point in time. Ma'am, I had one suggestion. Of course, you know, the other members have also articulated this very, it's a citizen feedback. I mean, we're not, you know, constitutional experts or something. So we really feel that, okay, you know, we wish that the center would intervene and help in our situation. You must be having your constraints. I mean, the center must be having its constraints. But one suggestion I'd like to make is that, you know, in March itself, as this pandemic started, there were a lot of TikTok videos which were anti-social distancing, anti-hygiene, those kind of things. And I think it could have helped a lot of citizens and medical care workers if TikTok, the IT ministry had come down heavily on TikTok and put a ban on it, because the community that was being targeted through those kind of videos is already not very, you know, educated and very prone to doing these kind of things. And just in the midst of a pandemic, it puts too many people at risk. So some, you know, tough action at that point might have helped, you know, slow the rate or, you know, alter the course of it to some degree. So I just wish that that could have happened. And, you know, if we can be a little more mindful of these kind of things, that these are things, you know, imposing emergency may not be the first option, but at least putting a rogue platform, you know, nailing them down is a more plausible and a possible option. So if that's something that the government can look at.
So we are still in the process of making rules and regulation as to how platforms have to work in the country.
Okay.
And unfortunate part of democracy, as I always say, is that it always gives strength to its own enemies. That's the problem with democracy.
Okay.
Now, TikTok comes from a country which does not observe those rules.
Right.
So they can cut, shut, do whatever in their own country. And they use the loophole of democracy to spread the wrong messages, which helps their cause rather than our cause. And that is the problem. And misinformation, misguiding people, in addition to wrong messaging, is we all have suffered from. But wishing a platform shutting down is not such an easy thing, especially when a certain section is using those services. And alternative was a Pakistani app, so which is again not a solution. And I've been told that it's a $34 mimic which you can do, and you really don't need much of technology, etc. But unfortunately, we've not successfully done it. So there are many gaps, and one such gap is dealing with these kind of wrong things. But end of the day, nobody wants to die. So propaganda needs to be fought. The bad propaganda needs to be fought with good propaganda, and telling people what is right and putting the right stories that this is going to kill you. And when people see that happening in front of their eyes, hopefully they will learn. And we saw all the wrong things happening, you know, spitting on the nurses, spitting here, there. So I think these are certain civic rules which we need to enforce and get people to follow it, irrespective of which religion they come from. And so some amount of civic consciousness also needs to be built. And let's all get together and work on those subjects.
Thank you.
And last five questions. Pranjal.
So they say Pranjal is not there. You are on mute.
Yuvraj. Aparna Sinha.
Hi. Hello, can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Hi, ma'am. Hi, Sureshji. Hi, ma'am.
Hi.
So my questions are actually answered by you, and it's going to be a rant. I'm worried about Delhi, the way it is imploding, and there is nobody who is actually to tackle the situation, and how, as a citizen, we are supposed to tackle the situation. It's not like that Delhi is going to affect Delhi. Delhi is going to affect Gurgaon. Delhi is going to affect Noida. Delhi is going to affect even the states adjoining it. But then we don't know. It has been answered by you. We have to do what we can do in our capacity. We have to be positive. That's about it. Like Sandeep has already asked the question. Malay has asked the question, and I had the same question. So that's about it.
Sorry, can't help it. I mean, it's by our pressure constantly. We hope Delhi government will act correctly.
Nilang Dave.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Namaste, ma'am. This is Nilan. Namaste. From Vadodara, Gujarat.
Namaste.
Ma'am, my question is slightly political in nature compared to the others, which are focused mostly on the pandemic for a change. So my question is that despite having such fierce and talented lot of politicians in Delhi BJP, why aren't the right faces projected, and why aren't the right people given the right responsibility? I won't take names, but people will understand, because being from a Sangathan background and being a fourth generation Swayam Sevak, I feel pity that this is the same Delhi of Madanlal Khurana ji, the same Delhi of Sushma ji, the same Delhi of the tall Jat leader Sahib Singh ji. Why can't we have the resources, ma'am? But why aren't the resources being utilized, and someone should be put up against the Kejriwal government from now only, so that in 5 years that person's face is recognized, and we have a much better shot. We didn't have a shot in the last two elections. People on the ground knew it. I'm sure you also knew it. But 42 to 50 vote share percentage is quite easily possible if we project the right faces and do the right tinkering on the ground in the Sangathan. Thank you.
No, I think, again, you are always wise from the hindsight, but decisions, when are made, they are made with some deep thought processes. Sometimes decisions work, sometimes they don't work. And I think every decision was a right decision also, because whatever Sangathan does, there is definitely a thought process, and which is in the interest of Sangathan. But at times your decision may not have brought out the results as you wished for. So nothing wrong with the decision, but it's just that results didn't turn out the way we wanted, and that's okay. That's life. And why should we ever undermine our opponent? I mean, in this closed door meeting, I can say this, which I may not say outside, that you are battling a strong opponent, and for that sometimes you will lose also. It's okay. You can't undermine your opponent. I think quality of opponent also needs to be looked
what
at.
What needs to be done for Meenakshi ji to come out in the forefront?
No, I am in the forefront. I am in the forefront. Yeah. I am not someone who's at the back ever. I'm in the forefront. I do my bit, and I do my bit with full faith and confidence. Whatever I want to do, I do that. And rest... I always say karma and the God. So for every karma, when I don't know whether it was Aparna or Ruchika who was talking about it, that we voted for BJP and we are suffering because of the three idiot Sarkar. So my answer to that is, there are more people who voted for those. So it's like law of inertia. When you are dealing with some wrongs, you need greater force for the right people to come on top, and greater force of right people in decision making, then greater benefits will accrue. But if there are wrong decision making happening at whichever level, the wrong dissemination will happen and people will suffer. So I guess you need higher energy, more energy to move the body in from a state of inertia to state of motion, or from state of motion to state of inertia, whichever way you look at Newton's law of motion. So you need higher force, more energy. So wherever we got left out, we need to push that forward.
The next question is from Pooja Tiwari, Delhi.
Namaskar, Meenakshi ji. Kaisi hain aap?
Bilkul theek, Pooja ji.
अच्छा, मेरा क्वेश्चन ये था. वैसे सभी ने इस बारे में बात कर ली है कि हम डिसमिस क्यों नहीं कर सकते आम आदमी पार्टी की गवर्नमेंट, लेकिन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के मुताबिक हम इट्स अ फेलियर ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन मशीनरी, बिकॉज फिजिकल ब्रेकडाउन एज इन टर्म्स ऑफ अर्थक्वेक आता है या एपिडेमिक आता है या जिस तरीके से भी, अगर लोगों को इस कोई भी प्रॉब्लम सिचुएशन इस तरीके की आती है तो सेंटर को ये पावर होती है कि वो इसे डिसमिस कर दे. और मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि जहाँ जाने जा रही हैं हम बहुत सारे लोग, अभी भी अंतिम संस्कार के लिए लाइनें खड़ी हैं, इट्स अ टोटल डिसफंक्शनल गवर्नमेंट. सो आई थिंक सारी चीजें जो आपने कर्म की कही और सब कहीं बिल्कुल ठीक है, वैसा तो होना है, लेकिन अब चीजें आउट ऑफ हैंड भी हो रही हैं. So can we not actually, why can we not, और ये अच्छा मौका भी है इन लोगों को, we can actually throw them out also. They don't deserve to be in power.
No. It's not for you and me to decide who deserves to be in power or not. They have been voted by people of this country. And there are people who are higher in number than you who have voted for them. So they are going to be in power. It's how we continue to keep building pressure on them to act rightly is what we need to do. We can't wish them away. We can't wish anyone away. They are going to be in power because that's what people have done to themselves. So no matter how hard you and I may wish that situations were different, and maybe different kind of people should have been in control of situation who would have had the country's interest and people's interest at heart, but that's not what has happened. That did not happen in this country for 60 long years. So you got what you voted for, and that's the brilliance of democracy. We can't wish it away. There are more people than you and I can think who have voted for them, and that's what they deserve to get, and we will get what we are getting because we are all in it together.
Last question of the day, Miss Aarti.
Aarti, you need to unmute. Unmute. Hi. Unmute.
Now, is it unmuted?
Yes.
Okay. Firstly, I want to thank you so much for taking Rahul Gandhi to court. It's like 500 birthday presents together.
Thank you.
And my question is COVID-related and also otherwise. I see a lot of these very popular websites which are very vicious and full of lies, bias, quaint, whatnot. So a person like me, I am a writer, but I don't have access to a lot of facts. And these people, they print lies. So even if I will tell my best friend, aisa nahi hai, she will give me 5 articles full of lies. Ye COVID ke time bhi ho raha, hamesha se hota aaya. So how do we as citizens fight this? Because I can write, I can articulate, but I will not have the facts. I will not be alone able to fight this machinery of lies which is there. So anything for a citizen like me?
Kuch aisi sites, aisi websites, aur kuch nahi to individual account. Na ecosystem theek karne ki zarurat hai. Jo people like you publish, or one of us publishes, each one of us should help build that narrative in sharing those stories and be active on sites and places where we can be. And we definitely need websites, magazines, and other places where we can articulate our point of view. And even if we are unable to do so, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, etc. We should use these means to enhance our reach. And we all should participate in supporting each other in sharing that point of view to as many people as possible.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Meenakshi ji, for taking time out and having this lively, enriching discussion for with us. It was a pleasure to have a discussion with you. And we would like that we can also have in future discussions with you.
Thank you. Thank you, Suresh. Thank you, everyone. Happy to have connected with every one of you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hope to see CM of Delhi soon.
What a pleasure. See you soon in better times. We'll meet over a cup of coffee and tea. Namo chai.
Thank you.
So we started Lassi also.
We would like to see you as a CM of Delhi, ma'am.
No. Who's interested?
We all are.
No, I'm not. I have no interest. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Suresh.
Thank you,
Suresh.
Thank you, everyone.
Suresh, bye. Nice. Great time. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you so much.